feels good just to, I just feel him all over me this life. I feel good. I tell you, it's just an honor to be in his house. And I got some good stuff to tell that he has for us tonight. We need to reassure each other of these things. And you know, Jenny loves this Revelation stuff. We're going to be in Revelations. I love Revelations. It's my favorite book. My favorite chapter is John 14. My favorite verse is Matthew 6:33 and Philippians 4:13. Amen. I tell you that, John 14, it's full of stuff. And Revelations, oh, I love Revelations now. I just get excited about Revelations. Praise God. Oh, it ain't supposed to be in my eye. It ain't supposed to be in my glass. What's the matter with you? Praise God. You got your Bible, turn to Revelation 21. There's some good stuff in there. All of this word is good. All of this word is what? Truth. Man, it feels good to talk about truth, don't it? We're going to talk about the gospel, which is the good news, which is the truth. And we're going to see. We're going to talk about the new Jerusalem. We're going to talk about the holy city. Did you know the holy city, New Jerusalem, is the bride of Christ? Hallelujah. Did you know the New Jerusalem is going to be the capital of the universe? And it's going to be moved from the, to the planet Earth from the planet Heaven. And it's going to be among men forever. Woo! Think about that. You know, God, now think about it. We're talking about the universe. God created the heavens and the universe and everything. You know, and I don't know. There may be something else out there. I don't know, but I'm not worried about it. But I know God created us. Hallelujah. And he loves us so much, he wants to come down here and dwell for eternity with us after this creation down here gets fixed, put back the way it's supposed to be, okay? And when that happens, the new Jerusalem from the planet Heaven is coming down here to the planet Earth to dwell for eternity. And let me tell you about, let's talk about that new Jerusalem. I'm excited about that, man. We got a mansion you can't imagine. I'm talking about, they've mansions up there, you know. The Bible says so. And in my Father's house are many mansions. Amen. But I want to tell you, I can't wait. I can't imagine our brothers and sisters up there shouting right now. Amen. Now, I want to tell you something. We're going to look at New Jerusalem tonight. You know what? You know there's a song about Four Square. Four Square. We're going to look at Four Square in the Bible, okay? Four Square is what? 1,500 miles long, 1,500 miles wide, and 1,500 miles high. That's going to be the city of New Jerusalem. And by the way, they're going to build a wall. Can you imagine Trump wanting to build a wall around America? But the Bible says there's going to be a wall around New Jerusalem with 12 gates. And in them 12 gates, they're going to be 12 pearls. God can make pearl that big, you know. I mean, we see pearls like this. We're talking about 12 gates with 12 pearls at each gate. And those 12 gates will never close. Woo. Four square, think about it. We're going to get in and look at it. We're talking about gold, diamond, jewels. We're talking about the foundation is going to, I'm just throwing it here. The foundation is going to be 12 jewels representing what? The 12 apostles. And the 12th apostle is who? Matthias. We see that in the book of Acts because the Bible said he was numbered among us. Amen? So we're going to see a Theus. I mean, his name's going to be on that foundation, those stones. You know, how many of us like to have a big diamond? How many like sapphire on your finger? You know, sapphire's pretty blue, you know. Garnet and all these valuable stones put on gold that we like around here, a little piece of it. Why, the foundation of New Jerusalem's going to be built out of stuff like that. Think about that. Can you imagine? The 12 gates are going to be named after the 12 tribes of Israel. And the foundation is going to be 12 precious stones, 1,500 square, by the way, you know. I mean, we're talking, oh, and by the way, this is yours and ours. We are going to inherit this. Can you imagine what we're going to inherit? We can't imagine, can we? You know, I still pray, Lord, you need to let me come up. He let some of the others come up there and take a glimpse. Now, Lord, how about letting us go up there and take a glimpse? We come by and tell everybody, amen? Paul the Revelator talked about it. He seen it. God's servant and God showed it to him, all of this stuff, and he wrote it down so me and you can look and read it, you know. Can you imagine seeing it, though? And I know what happened if God wished to let me see it. Guess what happened? I wouldn't want to come back. Amen. Think about it. It's an awesome thing, y'all. Praise God. Let's just look and talk about it a little bit, okay? Watch my clicker. Now watch this. I'm going to go to 21:16. How you like that? It's all right, ain't it? It's the old school part of it, you know. Look here. And the city lieth, was that what I say, four square? And the length is as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with the reed, 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height of it are equal. I say it was 1,500 miles square, 1,500 miles this away, that away, 1,500 miles. That's a big place, you know that? And you know what's going to light it up? God Almighty and His Son are going to be the light. And there will be no darkness in New Jerusalem. But outside the 1,500 square, which all saints will be able to live in and go in and out of, and of course the people of the earth, the natural people, will be able, the nations will come and honor God and give their blessings to the Lord, and they'll leave. They'll be able to go in because why? They saved too. They're not going to be no lost people because it's going to be a sinless society. Amen? And they're going to be natural people born, but they're going to be the saints, which is going to help rule and reign. Who is that? That's us that's in here, down here now. So we're going to be up there. Or not up there, I take that back. Down here. Think about it, y'all. We're going to be down here on this earth to rule and reign and be with the Lord for a long time. What about eternity? That's a long time, isn't it? I like that, you know. Ain't going to be no 3 score and 10 stuff, 80 or 90. It's going to be a long time, amen, for eternity. I always like to put it in this perspective. Y'all have heard me, some of you, say it before. What if a morning dove, Jeanette, that makes that pretty sound every morning that you like, come to this earth, took one grain of sand every day? How long do you think that dove, it would be until the earth would be gone? Well, that's when eternity just begins. Woohoo! That's a long time, isn't it? I'm excited. I'm excited. We're going to spend eternity with the Lord in this. Look at what we're going to dwell in and be in. And can you imagine that song, I Can Only Imagine? Look at here. It's four square. And we're going to look at that and see, so four square, we like that. And God's going to be, by the way, God is going to be here among men and women forever. And guess what? You'll be able to see Him. You know, He's alive and He's been seen before. Jesus has been touched and He come and dwelled among us and died on the cross. He was deity, God Almighty. You got God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Amen. Well, they're going to be in that New Jerusalem. They're going to be the light. It's going to be shining bright, by the way. There's going to be no darkness there. But when you come out of the walls, the seed time and the night and day is going to still continue for eternity. The Bible says that in the book of Genesis. You can see that. The seed time, the seasons, winter, summer, spring, is still going to do. planting seeds, still going to happen. The sun's going to come up and go down. But in that new Jerusalem, there ain't going to be no need for sun because the S-O-N's going to be in there, okay? Can you dig it? Amen? Now, that's something that's going to be exciting, y'all. We can't imagine what we're talking about here. Let's go a little bit further right here and look. And let me see where I'm at right here. 1,500 square. Think about it. Now, if you got your Bible and you want to follow with me in 21:16, we just read that. I want to read in 21:18 and 21. And let's just read about New Jerusalem in 18. Yeah, Ronnie, have it up there in just a minute. 21:18, what the Bible says here. Here you go. The materials, we'll talk about some of the materials in New Jerusalem, and I can't pronounce all these jewels. I get to hang out, and if y'all see me chipping on them or something, the foundation or something, y'all tell me, Rick, you ain't supposed to do that. Y'all might see me, I have a giant diamond over here, and sapphire over here, you know. And Roy going to say, you've been chipping on them foundation again, then boy, I'm going to get you. No, I'm going to do right up there. We're going to be 100% up there, y'all. You know, we ain't perfect down here, but we're going to be perfect up there. I truly believe that. We're going to be like Jesus, what the Bible says, and he's perfect. He's the only one that's perfect, and we're going to be like him. Ooh, that's going to be exciting, isn't it? Think about it. Okay, let's go a little bit further right here and look. In verse 18, I want to read, it talks about the materials in New Jerusalem. And the building of the wall of it was of jasper. How many got jasper? Anybody got any jasper? Buy some. I'll hold it for you. You got some? A necklace of jasper. Amen. From Alaska. Jasper. Think about that. Now, if you ain't got some of these things, just get you some. Look at here. And the city was pure gold. Woo, think about that. Talking about, can you imagine? It says the building of the wall of it was jasper. Can you imagine that? Remember we said 1,500 square. The foundation ain't going to be just a little bit like our church. It's going to be 1,500 miles long square. And there's going to be 12 foundations there of this stuff. Can you imagine walking up to go in the walls of that thing and the glitter and the shine and like, whoa. This is my hangout, baby. By the way, when we help the Lord Jesus down here for a thousand-year millennium reign, we'll be flying in and out of heaven. That's where we'll hang out, and we'll come down here and help him. Yeah. You read and study, you'll see some of this stuff. Let's go a little bit further right here. And look, that was verse 18. And the foundation of the wall of the city was garnished with all manner of precious stones. The first foundation was jasper. Now, I want to tell you, there's 12 foundations representing what? The 12 apostles. That's what we're talking about here. Amen? The first foundation was jasper. The second was sapphire. That's a beautiful stone, too. A third was chalcedony. I don't know what that is. What is that? Anybody know? Who's got one of them? Raise your hand. I can't even pronounce it, much less buy one. Sandra, you got one? Look here. Let's go to another one. And the fourth was an emerald. Now, some of you got some emeralds, ain't you? That's green emerald. Beautiful, you know. Birthstones and stuff like that. Beautiful, beautiful. And the fifth was sardonyx. And the sixth was Sardius, and the seventh was Chrysophyte. I can't pronounce some of these things, to be honest with you. And the ninth, topaz, and the tenth, a Siophoros, the 11th, a jacinth, and the 12th, an amethyst. Now, who can pronounce those? Raise your hand. I'll let you read them. Anybody in the house? Well, that makes a majority. I'm one of them. I can't read it. Nathan probably could. Is he here? But he ain't here tonight. Let's go a little bit further right here. And look, and we're going, We're going now. That's talking about the 12, the foundation, the materials in the New Jerusalem. Is talking about some of those things, the materials and the foundation of the 12 apostles. And Matthias, his name will be one of those, which you can see in the book of Acts 1:26. It said Matthias, you know, he took Judas's place. It said he was numbered among them, okay? Acts 1:26, if you want to follow through on that one right there. Now let's go on down a little bit further. We talk about it. Let's look at 21:2. It's name, source, origin, eternal location. Let's look at 21:2. There it is right there. I, John, saw the holy city. That old boy got to see it, didn't he? You know? How many is jealous? Raise your hand. I want to see it, don't you? We're going to see it. Look here. And I, John, saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming down from God. Now, where's it coming from? It's coming down out of heaven. It's prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. Who is her husband? Jesus. New Jerusalem is the bride. The saints are going in and out New Jerusalem. And if you read and study, you can see that. We might look at some of that too. Adorned for her husband, Revelations of John, the Revelator, which is 21:2. Now we're going to get in to Revelations 21, and we're going to go from 21, from 10 to 27. You got your Bible. And we're going to look at the outward appearance. We're going to look at the walls. We're going to look at the gates. And we're going to talk about the streets a little bit. You know, I used to accuse some of the folks trying to chisel on my street when I get up there. I don't want to see it, okay? Don't want it to happen. Think about it, man. Can you imagine looking out your window and the gold glittering at you? Man, have I got an inheritance of what? Think about it. Okay, let's go. Hang on for this journey. 21:10, let's start right there in 21:10, the Bible says, and he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and he showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God. So we know it's coming from heaven. It's up there, amen? Think about it. It's coming down here. And look at here. And we're going to look at the outward appearance of New Jerusalem. Having the glory of God, and her light was like unto a stone most precious, even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal. Now we're going to look at the walls and the gates, and we done looked at the foundation. And he had a great, had a wall great and high, and had 12 gates, and at the gates 12 angels. And names were written thereon, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Jerusalem. Now, I want y'all to look at that, circle that right there. And there was a wall, a great wall. Even God has a wall around Jerusalem. I mean, what's this stuff they don't want us to build a wall? Did you know that you go to Israel, they got a wall built to keep the Palestinians in order? Amen? It's a no-brainer. Did you know King David, they built walls when that went on? Did you know King Solomon had a wall that was so great you could run a chariot around on it? Think about it. There's something about building walls. It's called security, protection. We ain't got to worry about it because God Almighty has done defused the devil and all his the enemy stuff there. We're going to be living in that holy city, and we ain't got to worry about it, but it said he has walls. And there'll be 12 gates, but they'll never be closed. And people will be coming in and out. And when you get in there, they're going to be a river that runs down from the kingdom down through that 1,500 square. And they're going to be trees on each side. I'm not getting into them trees tonight. Did you know that? Did you know them trees are going to bear fruit every month? Did you know them trees are going to be eat the fruit from those trees and there'll be no sickness there? Think about that. And you can read on, you know, in heaven with our, I mean, not in heaven, but down here, in heaven, but down here, you know, you got to get them too. We're going to be down here. There'll be no tears, no sorrow, no pain. I like that. That's in 21:4 if you want to read and circle that in your Bible. That's an awesome thing. Amen? I'm not getting into the trees and the river tonight. I'm getting into some other stuff. But look here. let's go a little bit further and look. were made, the walls and the gates. And there was a wall and a great high and 12 gates, and the gates 12 angels, and the names were written on them, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. And on the east gate, and on the north gates, and on the south gates, and on the west 3 gates. And the wall of the city had 12 foundations. And in them is the names of what? The 12 apostles. There it is right there. Of the Lamb. And he that talketh with me had a golden reed to measure the city, and the gates thereof, and the wall thereof. And he measured it in an earthly thing in the city. And it lieth 4 square. We see that in verse 16. And the city lieth 4 square, and the length as a large as the breadth. And they measured the city with the reed 12,000 furlongs. And the length and the breadth and the height are equal. And he measured the wall thereof 144 cubits, according to the measurement of a man, that is of the angel. Now, we done seen in verse 18 on down to 21, we seen what? The foundation, the material of the foundation. We done seen that, all right? So let's go a little bit further here and look a little bit further. You know, you can really get in Revelation, you can go a long ways, okay? I mean, you can go back to the back of the first of Revelations, and what happens when you start reading Revelations, you see the seven churches and all that, that the Lord tells, you better get it right. I got something against you except for two of them, but I want to tell you this. You go in Revelation, start reading, the first thing you're going to see, it talks about you'll be blessed if you read it and keep God's commandments there. And if you got something going on and you need to be blessed, start reading Revelation. The Bible said you will be blessed. Sometimes when I get this away, I go in there and read Revelation, and I see that you'll be blessed if you read it. If you read a little bit of Revelation, the Bible said you'll be blessed. Read it. Read something about it. And so if you'll go on in there, and if you'll get to Revelations 4, it says hereafter. And what is that? Hereafter means the church is gone. We ain't that. We ain't down here no more. So from there up to around in here, the church is in heaven with God until we come back again. There's so much in Revelation I can't even touch, you know, what's in there. But I'll tell you something. I was watching Roy preach the other night. I learned this from Roy. It says, you know, if the church will hear what the word says, if the church will hear what the word says, and you get in Revelation 13:9, it don't say nothing about if the church will hear what the word says. It ain't there. Why? It's in heaven. You see? They're just confirming the church, which is us, going to be raptured out of here, okay? And Revelation's an awesome thing. You're going to see all the great tribulations, and you're going to see the trumpets and the veils and all that cursed and wrath and stuff is going to come upon this earth, the great tribulation. And guess what? We don't want to be in that, do we? We want. Did God say, did you read where God said he didn't account his children to wrath? Would you put your children through it if you could stop it? No, you wouldn't, would you? Well, God's God, and he's going to take us out of here before that great tribulation. I know we ain't going to be here. The Antichrist is going to rise up. When that happens, we gone. When he rises up, we gone. 7 years of tribulation like the world has never seen. Daniel the prophet, you know, talks about all of that. And you can get in Daniel and see it. You can get in Joel and all of those prophets. It's all confirms it and comes down to Revelation. John the Revelator put it down and you can see it. Amen? Is that awesome or what? Man, we're talking about an awesome thing. But we're talking about what? Us being saints of the Lord tonight. That means what? We are the redeemed, and that what means what? We're going to inherit this. It's going to be ours to dwell in the Lord forever and ever. Let's go a little bit further and look, and if I can find where. Oh, yeah. I want to look at 22, talking about the temple. And I saw no temple therein, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. Now, let's look at the light of the temple, okay? And the city had no need of the sun. Now, talking about the city, it ain't talking about outside the walls, okay? Inside the city, no, you ain't going to be no darkness. It's light continually. Outside, it's going to be day and night. But look here. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, neither shine it, for the glory of God did light it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. Ooh, is that awesome? Let's go a little bit further and look for more good stuff here. Let's talk about the trafficking in Jerusalem right here. And the nations of them. Now, when it say nations, you're talking, you know, this nation, that. No, you're talking about the people coming in. Okay, look here. The nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light. You see, everybody's going to be saved during the eternity with our God. Why? Because the earth is going to be a sinless society like God meant it to be before Satan failed and destroyed it and brought sin upon the earth. And Adam failed and brought sin back in the earth. If they hadn't failed, God meant the earth to be sinless then. He had a plan then. But praise God, he had another plan because them two dudes messed up. Amen? But let me tell you one who didn't. His name is Jesus. He carried it through for you and I. Amen? It's a done deal. And because of that, you and I get to inherit what we're talking about here tonight. Amen? Let's go a little bit further right here and look. And the nations of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it, and the kings of the earth do bring their glory and honor into it. And the gates of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no night there. And there shall bring the glory and honor of the nations into it, and there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defile, neither whatsoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie, but they which are written in the Lamb's book of life. Now that's awesome right there, isn't it? Is that awesome? Now that's just some of the good stuff we're looking at right here. Now let me tell you. I want to look somewhere here. Here we go. Some of the blessings in New Jerusalem and the New Earth. Now, what happens when I say that all things in the New Earth, it's not going to be a brand new, made New Earth. It's going to be all things are made new. Y'all understand? You see what I'm saying? It's going to be this earth, but it's going to be made new. In other words, there's sin, there's junk around here and all this stuff, and God's going to like purify it like gold, okay? When you purify gold, you heat it up and boil it up, and you get all impurities out of gold, and it's pure gold. Well, the earth is going to be made new. The earth's already here, okay? But it's going to be made new. Think about that. That's the Old Testament and the New Testament. Saints were promised the city New Jerusalem. If you get in God's Word and get back in the Old Testament, by the way, you need to read that Old Testament too, man. There's some awesome stuff in there, and it just goes right along with it confirms the New Testament and everything. There's some much good stuff in there. You know, you read it, you read in the Old Testament, look, you'll find things that you didn't pick up last time, you'll pick up next time. Anyway, look here. Old Testament, New Testament promised the city New Jerusalem. And you can see that in Hebrews 11, 10, 16. All saints to live in the New Jerusalem, praise God, you know. And I'll tell you right now, we're going to go to verse 22 and 7. God said he come quickly. And here it is again as you read Revelations and parts of Revelations. As you just go in there and say, I'm going to study this and get a reference Bible and start digging in. What does this say right here? Behold, I come quickly. Is he fixing to come? And he's going to come quick, ain't he? It's going to be like that. And he's coming, y'all. I'm excited about that. I truly believe he's coming in our lifetime. I believe the weird generation is going to see the coming of the Lord. Look at here. Behold, I come quickly. Oh, there's that word again. Happy. Blessed. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. What does that say? We're keeping it, ain't we? You're going to be blessed because of it. There it is again. And when you go in the first chapter of Revelation, it says you're going to be blessed because you're reading it. And now here it's telling us at the end of it, blessed if you keep the sayings of this prophecy, this book. Blessed again. Well, in that Revelation from 1 to 22, what are you getting blessed? Are you going to inherit New Jerusalem? Yes, we are. Think about it, y'all. Man, we got some kind of inheritance. Think about it. I'm excited about it. Look here. I come quickly. Let's read it. Oh, yeah. And another one I'm going to read here in just a minute. Behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keep the sayings of the prophecies of this book. Now, I want to go to think it's I want to go through Revelations 22:3. I want to read that, and it tell you a little something that's going to be, you'll really appreciate. Yeah, here it is. In Revelation 22:3, and there shall be no more, what does that say? Huh? There shall be no more curse. I don't know about y'all, but that's what's happening to this world down here today. That's why we're going through tribulations and things that's going on outside of our doors when we go home and read the news and listen to the weather and the news and all this stuff. There's a curse on this earth. And they say, well, why did this happen? I've been good. No, you was born under the curse. It rains on the righteous and the unrighteous, doesn't it? You know? What makes you immune to some of those stuff? God is with us. We know our destiny. We know we're going to be with him for eternity. And we know the people's going to hell and the devil and everything. What their destiny is, it ain't good. We don't want them to go there. God don't want them to go there. They have freedom, free choice to choose where they go. Everybody has that choice, a free choice. But I'm telling you, I really like this right here, what it said in verse 3 of 22. It says, and there shall be no more curse, but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it, and his servants shall what? Serve him. We're going to be in it, and his servants, that's us, we're going to serve him. That's going to be an awesome thing, isn't it? We're going to get to serve him. That's going to be awesome. Think about that. And look at verse 4. Let's throw that in there. And they shall see his face, and his name shall be in their foreheads. Amen. And then drop on down into verse 5, and you see the last part of it, and said, they shall reign forever and ever. We're going to reign forever and ever with him. Amen. That's an awesome thing, y'all. I tell you, there's so much here. But the Bible says in verse 12 of 22, it says, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to his work. It shall be, and I'm Alpha Omega, beginning and the end, the first and the last. I want to read this verse 7, 22 verse 7. I want to read that one. The Bible says, behold, I come quickly. Blessed is he that keep the sayings of the prophecy of this book. And we just had that up there. It's up there now. Now I'm going to flip back to 21:7, and I want to read it. The Bible says in Revelations 21:7, what does it say? It says, I got it in here. He that overcometh inherit all things. Now, what do we got to do? We got to do a little something, haven't we? Huh? The devil's going to come at you and I, temptation, and try to pound us down and discourage us and do all these things. But what does the Bible say? We got to be overcomers. And how can you be an overcomer? That's by the blood of Jesus, the blood of the Lamb. You are an overcomer because of him. And you just got to stand and endure to the end. That's what the Bible says. It says right here, and let's read it again. It says, verse 7, 21. I know it's in here. Just read it. Here it is right here. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. Raise your hand if you want to inherit it. Oh, we got a minority. We got a majority. That's what majority wants to inherit what? The new Jerusalem. Amen. We're going to inherit. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God. He shall be my son. Man, I'm telling you, it's going to be so. God is going to dwell among us. He's going to be our God. He's going to wipe away all tears, death, sorrow, pain, all that stuff's going to be gone. We are going to what? Inherit all things. We just read that. Amen. We have an eternal sonship with him. And there'll be no more curse. And by the way, there's going to be a freedom. And I got good neighbor from ungodly neighbors. We got some out there, ain't we? We have. I got a good one. Everybody ain't got a good one. I bet some of us could raise your hands and say, man, we got some neighbors need to go. But they ain't going to bother you no more. Amen. That's going to be exciting, y'all. That's going to be exciting. I'll tell you right now, we got something to be excited about. We're going to inherit the kingdom with our God, and we're going to see him face to face. Amen. Let's all bow our heads, and we're going to pray, and we'll talk to those folks on the internet. God bless you. Thank you for being here with us tonight. I pray that this message touched your heart. And by the way, you have a choice to go to heaven or to hell. It's your choice. You have a choice if you want to inherit the new a holy city of Jerusalem, all you got to say is, yes, Lord, forgive me for my sins. I humble myself. I'm sorry, God. I mean it. And start following him. And that's the sign. Start following him. Change your lifestyle. Become a Christian. Become a believer. God bless you. The Bible says if you confess him with your mouth, you shall be saved. So ask him to come in your heart. He loves you so much. Everybody that's here tonight, every head bowed, God bless you. God, I pray in the name of Jesus, help us to be worthy. Help us.